Hello everybody, this is Misfit from the Coop guys, back with some more Witcher 3. And we're in the middle of a quest to burn some bodies so that the ghouls don't feed on them after the battle that took place here at Velen. And yeah, I think I'm going to do as many side quests in Mulberdale as I can, if not just to level up, but just to try and get some of the basics of the game hammered down. And it will be a good way of exploring the area, because this is a massive area. All these undiscovered locations, and I'm pretty sure there's something interesting at every one of them. What is this here? Oh god, the sensitivity is a bit high on my controller. A bandit camp! Oh, I think we rode right through there. Well, it's a good thing we added it to the map then, we know to avoid it. But yeah, let's, new alchemy, turnip page, werewolf decoction. Oh yeah, I read some of the books that were, that I had on me, and I was wondering what the little red mark on my map was. So yeah, I read some of the books and it gave me some information about a werewolf apparently, which we haven't encountered yet. I'm worried about the day that we do, because they seem a bit more formidable. The lycanthropy is the as they called it in the note. Nope, there's something bad over here. What is that?
Come on. Damn, you're ugly.
Oh, that's a bear. That's a bear. Let's get out of the bear. There's another bear. Let's stay away from the bears. Basically, I don't want to get into a fight unless I have to. Mainly because I'm terrible at fighting. I'm getting better. But until I get to a position, there's a pack of wolves. Oh, they're dogs. They're level 1 dogs. We can handle level 1 dogs. Oh, I still have Igni. Crap. Get Quen back on, thank you. Quen. Thank you. Oh. Remember to dive. Let's try parrying.
Time to end
this. Oh crap. Remember the dodge. Thank you. Man, that dog looks like it was skinned. Okay, well, we got some dog. Let's just loot them for stuff. The tallow we can use. I read up a little bit on the oils. If we're gonna fight ghouls at the next area, we might want to Roach, get back here. We might want to try and invest in an oil for giving more damage to them. We'll look that up when we get closer. But I do need to eat some bread. We didn't give them too much food apparently, so that's good. Oh, hops.
Run, Roach.
All right. Well, we've got a road again. And we can put our sword away now. Okay. Alright, we can't be too far away. Apparently it's just up here. Maybe that's why the dogs were hanging about. Oh yeah, it's literally
Come on now. Sure stinks like a mass grave. Now for the holy oils. Hope they burn well.
That guy is level 6. Okay, time to go into our crafting. So, alchemy. Let's see. Can we make oils? Necrophage oil. Ah, damn. We need 2 more of those red flowers and we could do it. Let's see if there's any around here. I found one earlier. Oh, there's one. Okay, so we need one more beggar tick thing. And that bread really actually seemed to do. Oh yeah, we generate health in the sun. I forgot about that. That's nice. Might be good to fight people during the day then. Any more of that? Oh, is that the beggar tick up here? I think it might be. There we go. Alright. So, let's get back up to Roach here. And let's see about making this oil then. So, alchemy. Necrophage oil. Apply to a sword for additional effects in combat. Plus 10% power versus necrophages. Alright, let's make it. There we go. Alright, now how do we equip this thing? Oils. Apply oils. Open the inventory panel to apply an oil. Alright, inventory. To have a blade in your oil inventory, use it to apply it to your sword. So let's do this. Usable items. And let's put it on the silver sword. Right, that's the only one we can apply it to. Oh wow, our silver sword is taking a beating. There we go. Now your sword will deal more damage to opponents that are vulnerable to this oil. Is that a permanent thing? How long does it last for? That's a permanent upgrade, I think. Okay. Got our shield up, let's get to work. What is this? That is... That is different than a ghoul. Whoa, 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 whoa! Get away, get away! That blew up! What the fuck was that? Necrophage hide, rot fiend blood. Is there more? I don't know. Just appeared to be the one. Okay, well, let's just... Oh, that's the wrong button. We're gonna need that. That was different.
Now for a shot of Igni.
Did we take any damage from that? I don't know. I don't think we did. Thanks to Quinn, which I'm gonna switch back to now. Probably the most useful spell I have. I don't really know what the effects the other stuff have, but... I'm focused too much on stuff during the fight to actually think about using signs and spells and things like that. When I get better, I'm pretty sure I'll... that was Wolfsbane. When I get better, I'm sure I'll be able to do more exotic things. I bloody hope so. Alright. So, we've just got a... Still got a distance to go, and it's just after midday. So we've got plenty of health regen. I don't even need to worry about eating. As long as I have time between fights, I should be okay. Well, I should probably look for more of those red flowers just to make the necrophage oil if I need to. I want to be getting back onto the road. Because my little GPS waypoint navigation system doesn't really work well when you're going off-road. Okay, anything hostile on the road? Just some deer. That's alright. We can handle deer. Don't mind me, I'm just a way to burn some bodies. Alright. Where are our bodies? Probably a bit down here. Oh, yep, here we go.
Go.
There's someone there.
Shit, one's still alive.
Alright, let's get in there.
Damn, you're ugly.
Okay. Get the shield back up, thank you. Where'd I get hit from? Oils, potions, and bombs are consumed upon use and can run out. To replenish your stocks of these items, enter the meditation panel. If you have hard alcohol in your inventory, ultimately be used to create a new batch of every item you have. Alright. Let's look at this inventory thing. I take it our oil ran out then. Yep, I think so. Well... Where is it? Meditation. Oh, no.
If it ain't that fucking priest, it's corpse eaters. I'm done with this damn town.
A priest?
Oh.
We'd agreed to meet as usual, just a larger delivery. Good customer, I thought. Then they whipped out blades.
What? We're talking about a priest here, you right?
We still talking about a priest of the eternal fire?
I'd say so. Beat stained pricks can't be trusted. This one had ordered premium grade Fistech from me 3 times. Everything perfect.
Fistech?
But the fourth, his man came at us with knives, sought to knock us out of trade. Shoved me in that ditch with the corpses. Must have thought the ghouls would take care of the rest.
And to make sure, he hired a witcher to burn the bodies, destroy any evidence.
A witcher? Meaning you? So what now?
Nothing. Didn't pay me to burn the living.
Oh, thank the gods, it's true what they say. Though mutants, you live by a code. Oh, thank you, Witcher. What are you playing at? My bestie?
I still don't understand what is happening there. Was the guy looking for bodies or something? Well, anything useful in the area? Should we burn the bodies anyway? Yeah, why not?
Now for a shot of Igni.
Alakazam! I'm wondering if we should have done that. Oh, there's still a dead body here. There we go. Loot you. And we'll loot... where is it? Over here? Yeah. Alright. Let's get back to Roach. I think we need to go back and see the, that priest. Because something's fishy with this quest. Let me see. What does the quest say now? Secondary quest. Funeral Pyres, suggest level 3. Return to the priest of the eternal fire. Some necrophages from eating them, okay. No. That's the 2 other areas that we can go to. So that's probably why we're going to Velen first. Defender of the Faith in Velen. Interesting. Okay, okay. Alright. Well.
Not so fast, Roach.
Yeah, let's check the map. Where are we going? Where are we going? Jeez, we're going all the way up there? Oh yeah, he said he would be by the bridge to Novigrad. That's not Novigrad, is it? That's not Novigrad. Wait a minute, Novigrad's across the bridge. Oh, maybe it is Novigrad. Let's have a look. Yeah, okay. So that this is Velen and Novigrad. Okay, so as long as we stay south of the bridge, I think we'll be okay. If we go over the bridge, we might get into more dangerous areas. And this is suddenly telling us to go south. No, we want to go north. Oh, red flower, red flower. Nope, nope, stop jumping on the horse. Get off. There is badness nearby. Looks like dogs or wolves. I want the red flower, though. I didn't realize our oils ran out. I thought it was like a one-time use and then it would stay there until we put something else on, but... I didn't really pay attention when it said that like, when you're meditating it will just like re... If long as you have alcohol, it will redo stuff. Go away, dogs.
Hey-ya!
Hey-ya! Hey-ya, hey-ya, hey-ya! What's this? Whoa!
Slow now. Whoa.
Jeez, you just appeared out of nowhere, buddy. Are you a merchant? You are a merchant. Hello.
Greetings.
Hi. What have you got to sell?
Wouldn't mind a look at your stock.
Nice. What have you got to sell? You have stuff. It's like an alchemy guy. Honeysuckle. Cost 20. He's got some chicken, though. Let's not buy 13. Let's buy 3 chicken. Nice. Now, what can we sell? We've got... I noticed there's a whole thing for junk that we can sell here. So we could make some money off of this guy. So it can be sold to merchants or dismantled into crafting components. I have no way of figuring out how to dismantle this stuff, but... Old bear hide. Let's get rid of you. White wolf hide. I'm pretty sure that was worth more. I think the number in brackets is how much this stuff is worth. I think. Maybe we shouldn't sell this stuff. Doll. Oh, it can't be sold. Yeah, there's two different types of currency in this game. We have to go to Novigrad to actually exchange it, though. Oh, I really want to sell some of this stuff, but... I don't think this guy's offering good money for it. Well... That's alright. Goodbye.
Farewell.
Learning the value of money in a game is quite essential. I don't know if you guys were watching the Windward episodes that Reaper and I were doing, but in one of the earlier episodes I noticed that Reaper spent an exorbitant amount of money, almost enough to buy a new ship, on a set of cannons which only gave him one extra point of damage, which, to be honest, wasn't that much of an increase.
Come on.
Was that a scream?
Slow now.
Were those dogs chasing someone, or was that just...
Whoa there, Roach.
They're just dogs. We don't need to fight them, then. Let's just get going. Oh, and we're by the hanging tree. What a lovely place to be. And heading up to the bridge to Novigrad. Let's just cut through here. And that's a tree. Oh. Okay, I'm going the wrong way. I am going the wrong way. Wow, I was hoping the game was wrong, but nope, it's not. Get moving. So, too many dogs in the area. Person in distress. If the number to the left of an enemy's health bar shows its level, if it is red or marked with a skull, it means the enemy is stronger than you. In this case, it's best to turn back. Okay. Oh, deserters. Nope, we're not taking them on. Christ, are we just riding through a deserter camp? Whoa. Sorry. Oh god, okay, let's just go.
Transit passes at terrific prices.
Alright, well, sorry, I didn't mean to come and charge over your parade. Ugh, jeez. Shady merchant. That's not who I want to speak to, is it? Pass isn't an Novigrad, that's not good. Yeah, he's over there.
Find him cheaper anywhere else.
Shady merchant, let's
speak to you. Interest
you
in a pass. Cheapest around, right here.
Yeah, what are these passes?
What kind of pass are we talking about?
You don't know. Redanians hold all the fords across the Pontar. Can't get through without a pass. But you're in luck. So happens I've got a few to sell.
What? Could dress up like Radovid and buy a gilded carriage for that much.
What am I to do if you can't afford it?
100? No. Let's see if we can try and barter with this guy.
No deal.
Whoa, hold up. Might have a little work for you. Reduce the price for a job well done, eh?
What kind of work?
What kind of work?
Nearby. Just to the southeast. My sister's husband's got a business. He and some lads tidy up battlefields. Problem is, there's always swarms of shite bothering them, you know, in monsters drawing the corpses.
Yep.
Give them some protection, and I'll swing you one beautiful discount.
Ooh, that would be funny. Well, yeah, I'll give it some thought.
All right, see what I can do.
So, all we have to do is kill a bunch of ghouls and then we should be okay. Christ, there's really not much distance between the living and the dead in this game, is there? And if your sister's husband's got a business in cleaning up battlefields, he's doing a shite job if you ask me. Oh, we've got a guard here. And this guy who's looking... Oh, I thought he was looking a bit shitty. What was he taking notes of?
Well, Witcher, have you completed your task?
I have indeed, sir. Took care of the graves. Why hadn't anyone burned the corpses earlier?
Why do priests take an interest in the fallen so late?
The Church of the Eternal Fire's first duty is to the living. You've no notion of the work we did just after the battle. The wounded needed tending, refugees, pastoral care. We had sermons to deliver, donations to collect.
And of course, the money.
Relieved to hear it. What would the people have done without you?
And interestingly, why does a priest need guards?
So, took care of the graves. Interesting, actually. One of the corpses proved to be quite, well, alive. And pretty talkative.
What do you mean?
Fistech dealer. One of them survived. Had an awfully interesting story to tell.
Intriguing. I would purchase this story from you. For all time. Exclusively.
Okay. Well, either we accept his money for this, for hiding this Fistech stuff, even though I have no idea what Fistech is. I'm guessing it's some kind of necromancy. Or we kill them.
You can hire me, but you sure as hell can't buy me.
Ah. An impasse. Then it will be cheapest to kill you.
3-on-1. Surely we'll manage, Witcher or not. Take him!
Dead man! Dead man!
Oh. Have it, you cock.
Come on, come closer.
Important lesson, you cannot parry behind you.
You'll burn, devil's brood!
Oh shit. That was a waste. Holy crap, did we just cut him in half? Jesus! Okay. Oh! One of your items is in bad shape. Repair it, otherwise it won't work as well. Holy! Oh! Oh! Okay, that was pretty brutal. Okay. Okay. Alright. Well, we just murdered these guys with an eye shot of everyone else. Can we loot these people? I don't think it will let us. Let's loot the priest anyway. 200 crowns and a mace. Alright, that'll do. What about this guy who literally fell to pieces? That was an interesting fight. Right, I want to look at my sword then. I think my sword is the one that's busted. Okay, so it's doing -5 damage. The sword, silver sword, do -7. Apparently, only cost 30 to fix it though. What other weapons have I got? There's my Witcher's blade. The Temerian pommard. Okay, well, I wonder if there's a smithy nearby. I don't think there will. Well, there may be some in this town, but we can't get across that bridge. Okay, well, we've done that quest. I think we should probably head back to Mulberrydale. Is there a signpost near here? No. Well, let's just head to place custom marker there. Let's just call Roach and head to Marbledale. Hopefully there won't be any fighting on the way. But, to be honest, I think that's probably going to do it for this episode, so I'm going to head to Marbledale, and I shall see you guys there in the next episode. Take care, goodbye.
Don't let him catch his breath!